some stuff I do, people might not like it.
And when do you know that a song is a good song? Is that, do you know that right from the start, or is it just when you look back?
Well, yeah, I think you have. I always have a rough feeling of like, yeah, that feels pretty good, you know. I always listen to the melody, and I want the melody to like drop at the right time. And you don't want to give away too much melody to, you know. It's how you build it, basically. And if it builds really nice, it feels like a proper good song. Then yeah, you have a feeling. You know, but you still don't know. I don't care what anyone says. You know, you do have a feeling like, yeah, I really like that. But, you know, I've wrote songs that I thought were going to work on radio and they didn't. You know, and the ones that I didn't think would work on radio worked, so.
Which song didn't work?
Please Don't Stop the Rain. I always thought that would work on radio, you know, quite well. I mean, it got played and stuff, but it wasn't one of the biggest singles that I released. So, yeah, I don't know. I don't think, you know, unless you're Stevie Wonder or someone like that.
Okay. Yeah. Have you written a lot of new songs in the past couple of months?
Yeah. Well, the past 2 months, I've probably wrote 8 songs.
Okay.
Yeah.
So when can we expect a new album?
I'd like to say next year, but I think it's going to be 2010. I've got a feeling it's going to be early 2010.
Okay. So that's
because I'm going to take some time off. Make sure, you know, my head's in the right space to write the third album. I want the third album to be much better than the first two. So I really just need a bit of time to kind of think about what I want and what I want to do. But I want to take my time more than anything. I don't want to rush it. So yeah, I've given myself about a year, which is a, you know, a good amount of time to get a good album.
Do you still have the feeling that you're still developing as an artist?
Definitely.
In what way?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I'm just constantly trying to get the right balance between artist integrity, what I want to do as an artist, and what I want to say, and what works on radio. I'm constantly trying to fight. I'm constantly fighting the battle between something that feels really, really good artistically, but won't work on radio, and something that works on radio but loses a little bit of artist integrity. So I'm just really trying to just find a great balance between the two, really.
Okay.
You know, all my favourite artists like Van Morrison and Stevie Wonder have had hits on radio, but there's something about the way that they do it that is just wicked, you know, and I haven't got there yet. But yeah, I'm still young, so I've still got time on my side and stuff. But
do you have the feeling it's coming, that feeling?
As I'm getting older, definitely, because I know more what I want. I get more experience on making records. I'm getting a better ear for production, and when I get an idea for a song, I can hear it a lot more fuller in my head now, whereas before I'd probably just get a melody or a lyric, you know, whereas now I get a lot of the melody and the sound of what it's going to be and the beat. So yeah, I mean, I just want to be able to produce my own record and, yeah, get a bit more involved in it, really.
Okay. If you look to your first two albums now, in what way, what's the most noticeable improvement of the two?
Of the two albums?
Yeah, for yourself.
Oh, man. Well, the first one for me that I thought, you know, I was pleased with the first one, because I tried to incorporate a lot of live playing into the album, and it worked. You know, I was really pleased with the sound of it. It had a lot of energy, and the songs were quite simple, but, you know, effective, I thought. You know, whereas the second one, I wanted to try and make more of a record, you know, rather than a live recording. I wanted it to sound like a record more, you know. So I tried to, I think I improved a little bit in the sense that, you know, I had more of a idea of what a record it should have sounded like, a bit more like the second one. But I don't know, man, it's different. It's a different approach each time. I try and do something a little bit different each time so that, you know, I'm seeing what I can get away with and what I can't. You know, some stuff I do, people might not like it. I might look at it afterwards and be like, oh, that was weird. But, you know, I think it's important to try it. So I always just try and incorporate live and a good feel of a traditional way of making a song. And I'm starting to use, like, beats as well now, so that it's a little bit more of the two rather than one or the other. Mm.